Hi guys, thanks for clicking on the video. My name is Landon, and today I'm going to show you some basic movements for a very good at-home workout. So all you need is a chair, a towel, a backpack, and a space to work out, and maybe a belt. All right, let's get started. I did just want to mention that I have learned all this stuff just throughout working out by myself and with the help of others. I am no scientist. I don't have a degree in anything. I'm only a senior in high school, but I'm going to play at Seton Hill University for lacrosse, and they're a very competitive school. So if you're like me and you're trying to work out and stay in the best shape as possible for the next month or so while every single gym is closed, you gotta watch this video. Okay, so to begin my workouts, I always want to hit some cardio to get my heart rate up. So that way that means you're burning more calories. So to do this, I usually do a Tabata, which is 30 seconds of work and 10 seconds of rest. And you do this for a certain amount of time. I'd recommend about 8 to 10 minutes. So if I were doing this, I would do 30 seconds of burpees and then take 10 seconds off and then do 30 seconds again of burpees and continue this. And do this for about 8 to 10 minutes. It's up to you. But you really want to get your heart rate up. Next, I would move into footwork, and I have a speed ladder, but if you don't have a speed ladder, you can use just a line in your house, and I'll show you that. All right, so if you're just working out in your basement and you can't find a line because it's carpeted, you can use a belt like this. So it's good to do footwork after your Tabata because then your heart rate's still up and you get your sweat going. And then we'll move into the lift, which will help burn calories, not only like physical calories, but it'll also raise your BMR, which is your basal metabolic rate, and how many calories you burn by your body doing bodily functions. And lifting raises your BMR because you have to constantly rebuild muscle. All right, so for footwork, the key is to be as fast as you can and do it as hard as you can within a short period of time. So I do each footwork drill for about 10 seconds. And this is very good if you're in a sport because you always want to be quicker and faster than your opponent. First, I do forward, show it here. Next, I do forward hops, show it here. After that, I'll do a backward step with each leg, show it here. After that, I do sideways one step, so that is one, show it here. And then I switch legs, show it here. This isn't only good for footwork, it's also good for your handwork. And I can also do different variations to help my handwork and my speed, which also helps with my shoulders. So it's also speed and strength. Show that here. The key with footwork is to be quick and fast. And I'd repeat each exercise about 3 times, and I would go for 10 seconds for each round. So that way you're doing about 10 to 15 minutes of footwork and you've already done 8 minutes of cardio and now you're feeling good. You burned a bunch of calories and now we'll move into weights. So the first thing we will hit is arms. When hitting biceps, I usually use a backpack or a duffel bag. It's up to you. If you don't have a backpack, a duffel bag works just fine. And it's pretty simple. You just load the backpack up as much as you can to the weight that you can lift. If it's too heavy, take books or whatever out. If it's too light, add stuff in. And it's a basic curl just like this. So I would do, for these workouts, do as many reps as you can for 3 sets. So you go here, bring it all the way up, squeeze at the top and slow down. When you're down here, you want to fully extend your arms so that way your biceps are fully stretched out. Bring it up here, up to about eye level, down, and repeat this for as many times as you can for 3 sets. So here, there. You can also switch your hand position. So instead of having it up like this, you can have it here and hit a hammer curl. So here, so it's that's working at a different part of your bicep. So with the hammer curl, you're working more of your brachioradialis, so it's right here, and then comes up right here. With the normal bicep, or with the normal curl, you're working just your bicep right up here. So it's good to hit both because it makes your bicep look more fuller and bigger. So next we'll hit tricep. And I'm just using a chair right here because down here we do not have a couch. So you just want to do dips. Again, do as many dips as possible for 5 rounds because you're going to be tired from your biceps, so you're not going to get as many reps in. So keep on doing it and doing it and doing it until you just can't go anymore. And if you want to make it a little harder, fully extend your legs. So it's like this here, like up. And you can slow it down if you really want to make it hard. So you go here, up, pause, halfway, up, pause, halfway, up. All right, and do that for 5 rounds. And the third and final thing for the arms are our shoulders. So I'm going to use that same chair that I used for the triceps. If you don't have a chair, you can use that backpack. So you go here, so you hold it like this, then you bring it up here, here, and you hold it for about 2 to 3 seconds. So when it's here, and you only want to bring it to right about your nose, because if you bring it any higher, you're not using your shoulders. And then to hit the sideways, you can go here, 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 and then here. So you want to hit each side evenly. And you can do this for about 3 to 4 sets, as many as possible. So with these whole workouts, you want to go as many as possible until failure. Alright guys, next we're going to hit chest. To start off chest, we're just going to bust out as many push-ups as possible. Try and get about 5 sets in. By the end of it, you should be exhausted. So next for the chest, we're going to do supinated push-ups, but elevated. So that's going to work more of your lower chest. So you can see that my palms are turned this way. We're going to go down here. So here, fully extend here, and then up. So you really want to make sure that your wrists are here. And the closer you can get it, the better. Now with that same chair, we're going to do elevated push. With the different push-ups, like the elevated push-ups, it's good to switch up your grip so you can go wide, normal, and close. Now for the back, we're going to use that same backpack and we're just going to do high pulls. This movement's going to work a lot of your rear delt and your traps. So we're here, we just bring it up. So keep your elbows out here. Do as many as possible for 5 sets. Again, squeeze up at the top. Now we're gonna hit our lats. So we're gonna use that same backpack, but with this one, tighten the strings as short as possible so that they come really close. We're here, and it's just a simple row. Bring it here. If you wanna make it tougher, load the weight up, and you can do a pause rep. So it's here, halfway, up, halfway, down, up, do 4 sets for each arm, as many as possible. So we're doing the other arm again. When you're doing all these movements, you really want to make sure that you contract the muscle and you squeeze it. That means you're working it and you know you're working it. For this next exercise, you're going to grab a towel and you're going to lay on your stomach. It's kind of like a Superman. So this is going to work your full back, your lower back, and your upper back.
So you want to lay flat on your stomach here. It's good if you have your arms right here. You want to extend your arms here. Raise your legs up here. Chest up and bring it here. So you're constantly pulling out, and then you bring it to your eyes. Here, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And you're pulling against the rope, so you're pulling out like that.
So next, we're gonna hit legs, and we're gonna do this single leg chair lunge. You'll see. So this is really working our quad and our butt. For the next exercise, we're going to do air squat jumps for a minute. We're going to do 3 rounds of this. The key is to keep your legs at a 90 degree angle and just to keep on bouncing and don't stop. Guys, I just want to say this is my rest day and this is a really good workout. So if you like it, please like and subscribe to the video. Finally, we're going to hit our glutes. So we're going to sit on the ground here. We're gonna lay on our back. Hold on, give me a second. So here, and then we're gonna go one leg at a time. So keep the other leg straight. Get this foot as close to your butt as possible and raise up, keeping your back flat as possible. Here, squeeze for about 3 seconds. Slow down, up, down, up, down. Switch. So you're going to do each one as many times as possible for 3 rounds. Up, down, up, down. Again, keeping your foot as close to your butt as possible. Up, down. So finally, we're going to hit abs. So just do a basic crunch, but this is a little different because you really want to squeeze. So you're here, down here, and you're only going here, squeeze for 5 seconds, down. 5 second hold, really squeeze, down. Do 5 reps, or do 5 sets for as many times as possible. So that's going to work our upper part of our abs. Now we're going to hit the lower part of our abs. So we're here, it's pretty much the same principle, except here, now we're bringing it up here. So you get a little rolling. So here, again, 5 sets of as many as possible. Now we're just gonna do a minute and 30 second side plank for each side. So here, you want to keep it here, keep your arms straight up, and just hold it. Switch. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed it. I'll put the workout on the next slide right here. Please, if you do enjoy it and you do it, comment down below on some things that I can add or take away or help with other people. And please like the video, please subscribe, that really does help me. And show your friends because they might be sitting at home not knowing what to do for working out. All right guys, I'll catch you later in the next video.